Hello everyone, I am Maria Pascanales. I am a member representative of GRULAC Civil Society and one of the co-facilitators of the Gender and Access Best Practice Forum. I am here to present to you a little bit of the work that we do in this Best Practice Forum and what we intended to achieve during 2020. So to get started, you already have to be familiar with the nature of the Best Practice Forum. These are intersectional groups of work that try to collect the best practice, the experience regarding issues that are relevant question for internet governance from the different perspectives that each one of the Best Practice Forum take on. So in particular, I'm talking to you from the Gender and Access Best Practice Forum. We have been working on this since 2015. That first year, we touched on the issue of online abuse and gender-based violence and how this impact the meaningful access of women and non-binary people. In 2016, we look into the barriers for accessing the internet from a gender perspective, continuing with that work in 2017 with the identification of the needs and challenges of diverse women groups and with respect to the internet access. In 2018, we move on to look in the issue of the impact of supplementary models and connectivity on women internet access and diverse gender people too. In 2019, finally, last year, we touched on the participation and the barriers to have meaningful participation from women and gender diverse people in the digital economy. The way in which we organize the work in the Best Practice Forum, it's through online meetings, surveys, call for inputs, call for volunteers, all modalities that are highly collaborative, and we expect to engage with a community that can be as large as possible. So touching on what we will be doing in 2020, the work of our BPF, we decided this year to look for an assessment of internet-related policy processes and spaces to a feminist approach to determine whether and how they protect and foster participation of women and gender-diverse people, particularly the young ones. And in this, we will focus particularly in internet-related policy processes and spaces that address issues that are related with the concept of violence, harm, pleasure, and consent online. All this we try to do it and intended to achieve it in connection with the current situation in which the COVID-19 pandemic also has very relevant angles to be covered from a gender perspective, precisely linked to these issues of violence, harm, pleasure, and consent. So we are looking for integrated views of how the current situation impacts this exercise of right in the context of COVID-19. So what we look at, we will be looking for different experience at the global, regional, and local level of internet-related policies and processes and spaces that foster discussion around these questions about limiting violence and harm in the online space, but also in the other side of the coin, to foster the use of the internet for self-expression and pleasure with consent as a guiding principle. Then we will try to assess this different set of processes and policies that we collect that are going on in different places of the globe in order to put together recommendations and guidelines to develop different approach that focus in these issues that we have chosen for our work this year. And all these will be crystallized in a compilation of examples and good practices that will be present in our final report with our recommendation. So the timeline for developing this work will be between now and September, working with the community through calls, surveys, and outreach. Then in October, we will present our first draft of the report with the information that we have gathered and the recommendation that we have decided to move forward. And during November, we intend to enrich this work with the interaction during the BPF session and the IGF annual meeting in Poland. To provide all the collection of these different inputs and participation from the community in the final report that will be delivered in December. So as I mentioned, this is all a highly collaborative work across the whole year, and we invite you to be part of this. You can find information to subscribe to our list in the IGF webpage that has a subsite for the gender and access PPF, and we also have a collaborative document that is linked there in which you can provide more information or interaction in a non-simultaneous way if you don't have time for joining the meeting or participate in the list. So finally, I would like to present the other members of the group. You can see their names in the screen, and particularly thank our consultant, Sorina Telenau, that will be helping us to facilitate the work during this year. So thank you very much, and please, here you have all the information and the resources to join us and work with us during this year. You are more than welcome.